I'm Nivedita. I'm a student teacher in Vidya Global Academy. So here today I am going to talk about the importance of mind mapping. So mind mapping is a very common thing and I think most of you are aware of it. In the forthcoming videos, I'm going to talk about the importance of mind mapping for a nursery teacher. Today let it be a very general overview. So what is mind mapping? How will a mind map look? Let me just show you a simple example. When I show you, you will understand what I'm talking about. So yes. What can you see? The central box is topic, which means the main topic. And the boxes around the central topic is subtopic. It's a branch of that topic. And can you see smaller branches from subtopic? Yes, those are related ideas. So, those are related information, related ideas about the subtopic, the topic. Okay, let me get into a very simple example. So, what is mind mapping? Mind mapping is an ideal learning tool. It gives a quick overview of what the topic is about without getting deep into the full topic. It gives a quick overview. Like when you look at it, you will know what the main topic is and what is in it. What are the key points, key subheadings, subtopics. Okay. So, another thing is when there is a mind map, even a very complex topic will be very easy to understand. It will make it seem very easy. When we studied, many of us will have the practice of writing key notes, writing important points and studying, right? So that when you revise, it's okay to brush up those important points before the exam. So here, mind mapping actually helps that a lot. And also it is a very, very effective tool in remembering. So here, you can map out how many ever subtopics you want as long as it doesn't become a chaos and very difficult for you to understand. So there are few things that will make mind mapping more interesting and not boring. One of the main thing is usage of colors. Usage of colors, different shapes and proper connections between the topics and then sometimes images also. Let me show you a example of colors. Can you see? So the topic is... Hi. Here I am going to give you an example. A very simple but interesting one. Birthday parties. So all of us like birthday parties, isn't it? We need a host for planning a party. So let me be the host. What will I do? I'll take a paper. I'll jot down the list like inviting people, food, theme, decor and everything. And it will be a very big list. Say, I take a paper and I create a mind map for this birthday party. My central theme will be birthday. And the subtopics will be what invitation, decor, food, location, theme, activities, gifts. There are so many things. So, and there will be branches for this also. For a subtopic, there will be many related ideas. For example, decoration. What will decors have? Balloons, papers, party poppers, birthday caps. There are so many things. When you create a mind map, you make sure that nothing is left out. Almost your to-do list is complete when you make a mind map. You keep ticking everything on the list. So, and it's also very interesting. When you make it very colorful, you will feel very motivated to do also. Isn't it? So, mind maps are very easy, very effective. For a small birthday party, and I'm sure even for big business meetings, isn't it? Okay. Now let me just give you a small suggestion. When you do a mind map, let minimum of the subtopics, let the minimum number be 3 and the maximum be 7. More than 7 will actually be a chaos. It will be hard for you to remember the subtopics. Then what is the whole point of having a mind map, isn't it? Okay, this is a very small introduction about mind map. Next video, let's see some very good topic for nursery teacher and how mind maps come handy for them. Okay, thank you.